As President Obama prepares to hand off the fight against ISIS to the new commander-in-chief, Donald Trump, the White House says there is significant progress.
The number of battle-ready fighters inside Iraq and Syria is now at its lowest point that it's ever been.
The U.S. estimates there are now 12,000 to 15,000 ISIS personnel, a dramatic decline from the peak in September 2014 when ISIS had amassed close to 32,000 fighters in Iraq and Syria. ISIS had always been able to replace its ranks, moving people across the Turkish border into Syria, but no more.
ISIL now has no access to an international border, and this has significantly impacted the overall campaign because they are now a very isolated entity.
Based on estimates from nearly 17,000 coalition strikes, the U.S. believes 50,000 ISIS fighters in total have been killed over the last 2 years, its ranks slashed by nearly 75%. The top coalition commander says that's only part of the story.
We've taken back over half of the land that Iraq, for example, lost to ISIL in 2014. So I think that's a measure of the progress.
Now, the top priority, get ISIS out of its self-declared capital in Raqqa, Syria.
We also know that they are plotting attacks on the West. And we know that central to external operations plotting is the city of Raqqa. And that's why we need to get down there and isolate that city as fast as we can.
U.S. Special Operations Forces watch Raqqa around the clock from drones overhead. It's all led to key intelligence and a critical strike. One drone struck a vehicle with three ISIS leaders inside. Operatives that had been involved, according to the U.S., in attacks against the West. Two said to have facilitated the deadly attacks in Paris last year. But even with the death of many fighters, ISIS has not given up the fight. ISIS has retaken the area around Palmyra and captured Syrian regime weapons.
Some armored vehicles and various guns and other heavy weapons, possibly some air defense equipment.
The U.S. now watching closely to see if, in fact, those weapons, possibly including shoulder-fired missiles, will threaten U.S. troops.